So, you know, the way I think of it, James, is technology moves up in steps. You know, we went from mainframe to PC, you know, whatnot. That was a big step. And what happens is each step of the new technology proliferates, creates new capabilities, and produces the next step. And I think the step around 2000 was biased toward connectivity. You know, that suddenly all this cheap fiber optics and then satellites and also wireless came together, and it created a platform where more people than ever could compete, connect, and collaborate for less money in more ways from more places than ever before. And I came along and gave it a name. I said, it feels like the world is flat. And the reason I said that was because people were able to touch people they could never touch before. I call my mom in Minneapolis, and she tells me I'm interrupting her because she's playing bridge on the internet with someone in Siberia. Okay, and also people could touch you in ways they never could before. And that connectivity became fast, virtually free, easy for you, and ubiquitous. That set of technologies scaled, and I would argue they then produced the next step up, which was around 2007, which of course was kicked off with the emergence of the iPhone. Now, those suite of technologies were the iPhone, cloud, big data, and the beginnings of AI. And what that step was about, I would argue, was complexity. That is, what happened in 2007 was that complexity became fast, virtually free, easy for you, and invisible. So what all those technologies did together was allowed us to just abstract away so much complexity in so many things we never imagined. So
what's an example of that?
Well, I could go on my iPhone, and now with one touch, I could page a taxi, direct the taxi, pay the taxi, rate the taxi, and be rated by the taxi with one touch. Right. We abstracted away all that complexity. Now, the third step, which is, I think, what we're in the middle of right now, is that basically the world has gone from flat to fast to deep. It's all what you can do now with no touch, okay? It's Siri, give me all of James's our latest articles, you know? Right. No touch at all. I've been traveling a lot of places, and people are always nice to you, and they say, hey, you're working on a new book. And I'd say, well, you know, I just wrote a book, you know, about 2007, which is about the three largest forces in the world, the market, globalization, climate, Mother Nature, and Moore's Law, technology, all accelerating. So I don't have three new forces to tell you about. And in thinking about that, I realized that actually what's happened since 2007 is not that three new forces have manifested themselves. It's that these three have gone deep now. Now they've gone really deep, but what's happening now is they're all going fast. So the connectivity has gotten even more intense.
Right.
The ability to abstract complexity away has gotten even, you know, more rich. And then we're taking them both deeper into the economy so more people, companies, and places can participate in it. And so what I'm not thinking about is, because this moves, keeps moving up in steps,
right,
what's the next step, baby? So from flat to fast to deep, I think the next step is psychic. I now know your whole psychograph from your phone. I will just push you your groceries, push you the supplies you need, push you the information you need. And I think I could already see, I think, the one after that. And it would be called genomic. That I now have a watch, or I have smart clothes on you, that I can actually read your human genome, so I can tell you what health you what drugs you need to buy, what supplies you need to buy, that my neurons will connect with your genome, basically. So you go, Walmart tells you, we know, given your genome, these are the foods you should buy, and these are the health aids you need. And I think that's roughly where we're going, from flat to fast to deep to psychic to genomic.
To the genomic. But let's tear with the psychic or the AI portion of that. One of the things that's quite striking, so we've been doing quite a lot of research just on the impact of AI. And what's striking about that is that on the one hand, I think, you know, clearly, you know, businesses, individuals will benefit from the psychic when these technologies can deliver us and help us do things that we wouldn't do ourselves. We wouldn't even know how to do ourselves. It also seems as if the economy itself would benefit, because in the sense that, you know, as companies become more productive, as the economy becomes more productive, that actually helps the economy in terms of driving economic growth.
Right.
I think the big question for many people comes down to, how do we think about the ethics of these technologies and, you know, the mis- and misuse concerns about those kind of psychic or AI-based technologies.